We'll be ready. parents drink, did you have a nice summer?
Oh, Miss Lynch, we was...
Dominic, aren't you supposed to be in class right now?
I...
You were distorting, weren't you? That's a fine way of starting the semester. Well, Miss Pilatieri, are you going to stand here all day?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am!
Then move!
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am!
I'm sure glad she didn't give you no lips, son. You would have been a hell of a lot.
Shut up!
Summer nights away. I top shoe, the kid of the week. A brand new one shooting up the charts like a rocket
by the Belgian League.
Going out to Ronnie and Sheila, the kids that have most cool stores. Especially to little Joe and the LA Doms. Mr. Naaman want to give it a spin.
Well, now, give her a break.
Thank you. Cindy.
Hello.
How are you, Mark? Hey, what happened to your ear?
Nothing. Just an accident.
Hey, hope you're not bothered about that first day at school. I mean, I'm being sorry about that. I mean, you gotta understand, why was it me, you know? Well, it was me, but it wasn't me. I mean, I guess it's interesting, you know? I mean,
oh, come on, can you tell us glad to see you, Cindy?
I don't know. You came a little nice to me in front of your friends.
Oh, are you kidding? Oh, come on, you don't know those guys. I mean, they just see you talking another chick. By the way, the thing she puts. What do you know of me, huh?
Well, it looks to me like maybe you had another girlfriend or something.
Oh, are you kidding, Sandy?
Sandy, if you talk to me, I wouldn't even look at another chick with you, huh? Hey, we're going to party in the park tomorrow night. Frenchie, she's going to quit school again while she's going to go to beauty school, so, would you like to go down with me, huh?
Oh, I'd love to. But I'm not so sure those girls won't be around anymore.
Oh, come on, Sandy. No one's going to get frisky if you know I'm around, okay, huh?
Okay, Danny, as long as you're with me, let's not let anyone come between us again, okay? Hi, Danny! Don't let me interrupt. One of you told this for a while. You never guess what I found out after in my house the other night. My mom thinks you're cute. Such a lady killer. Oh, isn't he, though? And what were you doing at her house?
I was just copying down some homework, huh?
Being a Lutheran, I can eat anything.
Yeah, that's the nice thing about being Petunia Pete.
Thank you. Thank you. Dreamtown Music on WAFX. With a popular success from last summer, it's raining on prom night.
Request for slower. How about it, Johnny Cino?
Okay, Vince, this little number's called Enchanted Guitar.
But don't forget, only 10 more minutes of big hand job contest! So if you got a steady, get on ready.
Daddy, is that a Billy?
Okay, I'll call this tune anything. Now, I think you've all been glad to know that I'm not judging the dance contest. Alright, alright. I'd like to present to you Mr. Vince Fontaine. Mr. Fontaine? As most of you know, Mr. Fontaine is a radio announcer from the House of Wax. Dig the scene on Big 15. Now, for the rules. One, all couples must be boy-girl.
Hey, too bad, Eugene.
Excuse me. Two, if you are tapped on the shoulder by Mr. Fontaine, then you must leave the dance floor immediately. Three, any tasteless or vulgar movement, then you will be disqualified.
I just want to say, truly, in all sincerity, Miss Lynch, that you're doing a really trippy job here. And I bet sure these kids would like to have you for a teacher, so I bet in all sincerity, she's really trippy. Is she trippy, kids?
Yeah!
Only thing I want to say is enjoy yourself, have a ball. Cause like we said, Big 15, where the tracks hang out, if you're having fun, you're number one. Some lucky guy and gals can go popping home with a stack of terrific prizes. But don't feel bad if you're bumping this out. It don't matter if you win or lose, just watch what you do with those dancing shoes. Say, catch the door, means the Ramskins, and away we go!
Same parade.
With a worse reputation.
Oh, that's very nice. Congratulations to both of you. And here are your prizes. Two radio stations from the House of Wax, autographed by Mr. Fontaine. Two driving theatre tickets, good on any night. Excuse me. Thank you. Two book coupons worth $10 from Robert's Hall. And two sofas designed by Mr. Schneider's art class.
Come on, one next ready. Let's hear it for these kids. The only thing I want to say is you kids are right on the greatest. Last dance, ladies' choice.
Super burger.
Yes, all right.
buck.
Aw, hey, Frenchie, maybe I'll come down to your beauty school sometime this week, and we can grab a coat or something.
Yeah, sure. Jeez, what am I gonna do? I mean, can't just tell everybody I dropped out of beauty school already. And go to the palace for a job while the guy's sitting around. Boy, I wish I had one of those guardian angel things like how that Debbie Reynolds movie. Wouldn't that be neat? Someone always there to tell me what the best thing to do?
Your story's sad to tell.
And you tell me which one hurts more.
Hey, watch it with that pink pimple pus.
Oh, what's the matter, Lassie Airy? Afraid you might get permanent.
Hey, listen, chicken fat, you're gonna look real funny cruising around the neighborhood looking like you wet your panties.
Why don't you use that thing then?
Hey, well, let's see you try that again.
Hey, what's the matter, Kinnicky? Come on!
Okay, Rump, how's about moaning the flaming dukes?
Concert!
Oh, great! Hey, guys! Wait up! It's bloody cold out
left for me. And love has been the one.
projects, we needed a record player.
Hey, French! Don't mind her, Sammy. Come on, let's go help Jam fix food.
Get close, Sammy.
Jesus, Crystal, you're a barrel of last night. Have you, friend?
Huh?
Your friend? Your period?
Oh, don't I wish him about 5 days late.
Think maybe a PG?
Oh, I don't know. Big deal.
You can't let a thing like that happen anyway.
Well, it wasn't my fault. The guy was using the thing, but he broke.
Oh, how?
Hey. I know. He got into the gas station, you know, one of those faltering body jobs.
Gee, what did she say?
Hey, it's not the next minute.
Nah, you don't know who the guy is.
Oh, no, it's fine. You know, if this job came in the den, I'd find an aspirin in my coat.
Huh. How much you won't tell anybody, huh?
I won't tell.
Hey, you guys, what happened to the music?
What if you play another record or something?
Yeah, sure.
I could stay.
come over to my house to watch the Mickey Mouse Club?
Yeah!
May not you, Pete.
Yeah! can, you lot. Once again, it has come to me to keep you sitting down here for a little longer, I'm sorry. I find myself in the position of thanking lots of people. Again, as if I were thanking them for me, when really that's nothing to do with me. I'm thanking them on behalf of this lot here. So it's as a representative of this lot here that I'm going to thank the people that I'm going to thank, because everybody is doing it for this lot here and for this show. First of all, I'd like to thank the PTA for the refreshments that they provided for the four nights that we've been here. I would also like to thank our caretaking staff who've put up with the amount of time that we've had to spend in here outside of school hours. Onto individuals, I would like to thank Helen England for the ticket design and the program design as well. Helen is also part of the chorus over there. Waving. I'd like to thank Lynn Walker, who did the front of house, who always makes me nervous when she comes up to me 2 days into the ticket sales and says, oh, we've got a sellout, so we better have a show. I would like to thank props, which were orchestrated by Judith Williams. I think she's backstage here. Is Judith there? Is Judith there? Judith is hiding somewhere. Come on, Judith, come on stage. On the subject of props, I think a big special mention must go to Mike Root, the designer and builder of Priest Lightning. Next up, I'd like to thank the makeup artists for making such an ugly bunch look quite presentable. That's Lucy Garrett, Sally George, Amy Pigeon, Judith Williams, Beverly Varley, Yvonne Root, Anne Heal, and a bunch of Year 10 pupils, which they did very well, thank you. Next, we'd like to thank our scenery artists, who were... Where are they? Simon Driscoll, Paul Carey, Jamal Tahar, Jim Meek, and Tim O'Rourden. I think it looked pretty good. I don't know if any of you heard about our little accident on Wednesday, but I would like to thank the lighting boys up at the back. Despite the fact that we nearly had to pull the plug at one point when one of them burst into flames. So, thank you to Alex Baldwin, Lawrence Rose, Ben Shepherd, Darren Jeffrey, Matthew Simpson, Dean Owens, Kim Wilson, Nick Chandler, Karim Taha. I think that's about it. Well done, boys. Thank you. Now, we've also hired in quite a lot of very expensive sound equipment for this show. And one of the funny things about that was that none of the staff actually knew how to use it. So we were very lucky in that we had a Year 11 pupil who has been used to using this and has done an absolutely sterling job up there for the whole of the performances. I'd like to thank Simon Hughes, who's done half of those people all dressed in black who run around backstage and bring things on and take things off and fall over and generally get in the way of the actors, you know. But I would like especially to thank the two stage managers, Martin Roots and Jamal Tahar. an awful lot of hard work was also put into the choreography of this show. basically because I've got too many feet and don't know how to dance whatsoever, so I did call on the help of several people, including Amy Pigeon. Where's Amy? Come on out, Amy. They're just getting engaged, isn't that sweet? And Helen England as well. Thank you, Helen. Thanks again. And especially to our chief choreographer, Alison Bedford. Costumes tonight were absolutely stunning. Apart from that, several people are putting an awful lot of time. I mean, each of these jackets, the pink ladies' jackets. Come on, put a pink lady, stand up, give us a twirl, please. Don't you think they're out of mind? We're selling them after the show if you're interested. But I would like to thank our three principal costume designers. Sue Murphy, who isn't here with us tonight, and neither is Kay Ager, who's ill, but Liz Bridge certainly is. Next up, I would like to thank our musicians. I think the band have performed absolutely special thanks to our choral director, Sarah Clark, here, please. Thank you. Musical director, Mr. Chris Lamberti. Yeah. It's a toy submarine. well, that's just about it from me. I would like to thank you lot. Because you have been absolutely superb for all of these performances. Thank you very much. This is also a goodbye for a few people on here, because we've got... we do have some Year 13 pupils who are in the cast, and this is obviously their last production. In a couple of cases, it was their first production as well, and I think they're bitterly regretting not getting involved earlier. Tommy Dickinson has been in the productions... basically anything that involves standing on the stage, Tommy's been involved in since he's been here. So every play that's been on at the school, Tommy has had a part in it. So it's a fun farewell to Tommy. And also to Helen Martin and Kevin O'Brien, our head boy and head girl, who acquitted themselves absolutely superbly tonight. So thank you. They're both great ambassadors for our school. And that leaves me just one goodbye. And I'd like to say goodbye to Stuart, who has been our leading man. Who's been in all three of the plays that I've put on at this school and has been our leading man for the last 2 years. He has been absolutely superb and in every essence of the word, an absolute star. And I would like to thank Stuart and to say farewell, and I hope that you continue to be a big Are you ready?